Chinese Taipei pair against Kia and Soga. Question is, who are their opponents going to be in that showpiece match? Well, we're about to find out. Umpires are now on court, which means the players won't be far behind. Top seed safely on court.
Ladies and gentlemen, representing China, Pira, Heidi, Ping, and Shen Chang Yun.
And their Chinese opponents. Certainly in form, that much we know. Of the Thai Masters only last month. First meeting between these two pairs. That's one of the intriguing stats about this second semi.
You won the toss. You serve. That side. Who will receive? You will receive. Keep your back that side. Thank you.
Sin, 29 years of age now, had been as high as six in the world, and that was only just over 6 months ago. World Championship bronze medalist, of course, from 2021, and they added an Asian Championship silver medal last year. Partner Tio Yi is just a year older. 5 titles as a pair, these two including one World Tour event, that was the Thai Masters back in 2020. Taken to 3 games by Lundgaard and Vestergaard of Denmark in the second round.
Ready to play.
Otherwise, it's been fairly straightforward progress. Well, the Malaysian pair and their opponents, Virju Tin, ranked at 14. They were number 10. Well, he was number 10 with a different partner. Former World Junior Boys Doubles champion, Virju Tin. World Championship silver with Tan Xiang a few years back. And there's his current partner, Ren Sheng Yu. Mentioned that they won the Thai Masters last month. And last year was a good one for them as well. They won the Spain Masters and then a bigger event, the Super 500 Japan Masters as well. A real battle yesterday against the local pair, Lambsfuss and Seidel. Came through 21-15 in the decider. It's in Suman of India. In the umpire's chair.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Tha Chieh Ting and Ren Cha Chuen, China. And on my left, Ong Yong Sen and Teo E. G. Malaysia. Teo E. G. Kusok to He G. Teng Love All. Play.
So here we go then, second men's doubles final underway. And you would imagine that winning that event in Bangkok weeks ago would have given Huer and Ren a massive amount of confidence. Even though they're number three seeds up against the top seeds from Malaysia, I think there's an argument to be made that they should start favourites here. A pair in red. Well, a bit of lack of communication there between Ong and Teo. Don't see that too often. Left that to each other. Lovely bit of deception from Teo from the back of the court. Wonderful rally. We might see a few of those kind of exchanges between these two pairs. Late decision, but a good one. Rather easier leave that. Can't give that kind of ammunition for Ren Xiangyu. Very straightforward put away. Awakening this for Ong and Teo. Top seeds being absolutely demolished at the moment. Only been playing for 4 minutes. We're nearly at the mid-game break. Oh. Well, I said they'd be favourites. I didn't expect this kind of a scoreline. 11-3, mid-game interval, inside 5 minutes. Wow. Well, somehow, and it's easier said than done, Ong and Teo have to find a way, get themselves back into this match. Not often you see number one seeds dismantled like this. Sometimes the harder you try, the worse it gets. Well, they were at least more competitive in the rally, but still came out on the wrong end of it. Just a ridiculous scoreline. This isn't just some also-ran pair being demolished here. They're the 12th-ranked men's doubles pair on the planet. It's going to go wide. Oh, did that land on the line? I think it did. They're going to challenge it, but I think there's a slight drift here, right to left as you look. And I think the drift may just have taken it onto the line. I don't think it's going to make any odds in terms of who wins this game. But let's see what Hawkeye makes of it. Just clipped.
Five.
Well, at the moment, they're just finding winners at will. 15 game points, would you believe? Inside 10 minutes. Absolutely incredible. 21 points to 5. Top seeds taken to the cleaners. And Hua and Ren looking absolutely magnificent. They lead. One game to love. Probably say it is a slight advantage playing from the far end as you look on the screen, but I think the advantage is only fractional. And the difference between the two pairs in that first game was colossal. That was nailed though. Much better. Going to be a little bit of pride at stake, you would think, as well here for Ong and Teo. Got across there so quickly. Four, Even on those kind of points that really they should have won, they end up sacrificing with an error. Smartly across again, Ren.
Six, three.
Just moves so well as a pair. Beautiful to watch. It's almost a kind of telepathy almost going on. They know when they're being covered by the partner. That's a nice shot. So they've already got as many points now in the second game as they did in the first, the Malaysian pair. Still really can't get anything going, can they, Ong and Teo?
Thank you.
Well, the crowd's trying to give him plenty of encouragement. There have been a few come on Malaysia shouts. And the scoreline now at least has a very respectable look to it. So a three-point lead for the Chinese pair as they go to the interval, but at least this is much more of a match than it was in the first game. Well, the let cord helped at the start of that rally. Oh, well played, well anticipated. Excellent that from Ong. Well, we've seen it very, very frequently in this sport. Things can change so quickly. All of a sudden, seriously, game on here. First time we've seen that today. You have to serve from below 115 centimetres. Service judge Satyawan Mahadu. Not convinced that was the case. So Hawkeye pressed into service again. Well, who'd have thought it? All square, Malaysians. Trailed 10-6 at one point in this game. Incredible reactions from both men at the net there. Tijing hasn't really put a foot wrong at any stage of this match. Well, he was in, I was going to say he was in two minds. He was in about five minds. Play it, leave it. In the end, made the wrong choice. It was well inside the line too, wasn't it? Fantastic entertainment for big crowd here. Inside the Western Energy Sports Hall. It's long. Lovely shot, and it brings up five match points for Huer and Wren. Well, it was much closer the second game, but they were still the better pair. And Hu Jiting and Ren Xiang Yu take down the top seeds here in the men's doubles. And we will see them tomorrow, and they'll start big favourites to win the title. It's only taken 34 minutes. Second game was more than twice as long as the first, which tells you how short the opening game was. But very, very worthy winners. 21-5. 21-15, confirming 34 minutes the match time. We're going to take a short break. Coming up, we've got our first women's double semi. It's a China versus Chinese Taipei affair in a couple of minutes. What a warm welcome back to Mulham on the River. And we have reached our fourth match of the day on semi-final Saturday. And it's our first women's doubles offering. Li Yijing and Luo Xumin up against Xu Yaqing.